Good morning to all. In the last classes we discussed about the derivation part, Hartley oscillator, Colpitts oscillator, so and so. Okay, today I would like to explain Colpitts oscillator. So the Colpitts oscillator is the LC oscillator, an LC oscillator which uses two capacitor reactances. Okay, this is the tank circuit. It uses the two capacitor reactances and one inductance. Okay, two capacitances are in series, so inductance is the parallel. So which uses the two capacitor reactances and one inductor reactance in the feedback network, that is the tank circuit. So that is tank circuit is called the Colpitts oscillator. So amplifier introduces 180 degrees phase shift, and the tank circuit also provides further 180 degrees phase shift. Okay, totally 360 degrees phase shift, 0 or 360 degrees phase shift. Okay, this is the output waveform. Radio RFC is the radio frequency choke, and R1, R2 are the biasing resistors, and C1, C2. CC1 and CC2 are the coupling capacitors. Okay, this is the transistorized Colpitts oscillator. So in this amplifier also uses in common emitter configuration. So this is the common emitter configuration. Derivation of the frequency of oscillations. In this Colpitts oscillators, we use just the two capacitances and one inductance. Okay, so IC is the output current, which is IFE, IB, act as an input to the feedback network, while the base current IB act as the output current of the tank circuit. So flowing through the input impedance of the amplifier, HIE. So the equivalent circuit of the tank circuit is this one. This is the equivalent circuit of the tank circuit. Two capacitances and one inductance. IV current is flowing. This resistance is the HIE, and this current source is the HFE IB. Okay. Converting the current source into the voltage source, we get the equivalent circuit is, so this current source is converted into the voltage source. So converting voltage source in series with the capacitance. Okay. So this is the simplified equivalent circuit. So in this V0 equal to, so output voltage equal to, in this one HFE IB. This is the HFE IB and this is the XC2. So XC2 means 1 by J omega C2. So HFE IB XC2 equal to HFE IB into 1 by J omega C2. See, the total current I drawn from the supply is, where I equal to voltage by resistances. That is the minus in this negative sign, minus V0 by XC2 plus XL. This is the XC2. Okay, so XC2 plus L plus XC1. XC1 is parallel with the HIE. Okay, in this one, these two are series and these two are the parallel. So minus V0 by XC2 plus XL plus XC1 plus parallel with the HIE. This is the total current I. And XC2 plus XL. Okay, this is the XC2 plus XL equal to, XC2 means 1 by J omega C2. XL means J omega L. And XC1 is a parallel with the HIE equal to, XC1 is the 1 by J omega C1. That is parallel with the HIE. that is equal to, both are in parallel. So 1 by j omega c1 into hie by 1 by j omega c1 plus hie. That means that equal to hie by 1 plus j omega c1 hie. Substituting the equation 2 in this. Okay, these two in equation 2 substituting. So I equal to this one. Replacing j omega by s, we get. So I equal to replacing j omega by s in this 1 by j omega c2 is replaced with the 1 by s c2. In this 1 by j omega c2 replaced with 1 by s c2. Okay. So in this j omega c1, that is the s c1, and 1 by j omega c1 is the 1 by s c1. So I equal to minus HFE IV 1 by SC2 by LCM. Okay, in this one. So simplify this. Finally, we get I equal to in this one. So according to the current division in the parallel circuit, current division. So IB equal to, so in this I into XC1 by XC1 plus HIE. So in this IB equal to, in this IB, this is the IB current. So IB current equal to, so I into, so current flowing I into XC1. So XC1 is the parallel combination. So XC1 by HIE and C1 is the parallel combination. So I into XC1 by XC1 plus HIE. That means IB equal to I by 1 plus S into HIE C1. So substituting equation 4 in equation 5. This is the equation 4. That is substituting in equation 5. I. Okay. In this one. So IB, IB is cancelled. So finally 1 equal to in this equation. And finally replacing S by J omega. S square by minus omega square. And S cube by minus J omega cube. So we get 1 equal to minus HFE by minus J omega cube L C1 C2 HIE minus omega square LC2 plus J omega HIE into C1 plus C2 plus 1. Okay. In this. Okay. Finally, in this equation. Simplify this in this. So there is no need to rationalize this, as there are number of J terms in the numerator in this equation. So it can be seen that to satisfy the equation, the imaginary part of the denominator of the right hand side must be zero. So that is equal to that, this is the, okay. So omega HIE into C1, this is the J omega HIE into C1 plus G2 minus omega square L C1 C2, that is equal to 0. So in this equation, C1 plus C2 minus omega square L C1 C2 equal to 0. This is the 0 by neglecting the 0 value of the omega. So in this omega square equal to C1 C2 by C1 L into C1 C2. So that is equal to 1 by L into, this can be written as C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. So W equal to 1 by square root of L into C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. Now C1 C2 is nothing but the equivalent of two capacitors. Okay, C1 C2 in series, C1 and C2 in series. So C equivalent equal to actual gain, C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. So this can be written as C equivalent. So W equal to omega equal to 1 by square root of L into C equivalent. Omega means 1 by 2 pi f, that is equal to f equal to 1 by 2 pi square root of L into C equivalent. So this is the frequency of oscillations in the Colpitts oscillator. So substituting this frequency in equation 4 and the equivalent, equating the magnitudes of both sides, so the restriction of the value of the HIE can be obtained as HFE equal to C2 by C1. Okay, this is the Colpitts oscillator. And the next topic is crystal oscillator. Okay, so the crystal oscillators. Already we discussed crystal oscillators. The crystals. In this, the crystals are either naturally occurring or synthetically manufacturing, exhibiting the piezoelectric effect. Main crystal oscillators are exhibiting the piezoelectric effect. The piezoelectric effect means, under the influence of the mechanical pressure, the voltage gets generated across the opposite phases of the crystal. Okay, piezoelectric means under the influence of the mechanical pressure, the voltage gets generated across the opposite phases of the crystal. If the mechanical force is applied in such a way that the force to the crystal is vibrate, okay, the AC voltage gets generated across it. In this, if the crystal is subjected to AC voltage, it vibrates, causing mechanical distortion in the crystal shape. So every crystal has its own resonant frequency depending on its cut. So under the influence of the mechanical vibrations, the crystal generates an electrical signal of very constant frequency. The crystal has a greater stability in holding the constant frequency. The crystal oscillator is basically a tuned circuit oscillator using the piezoelectric crystal as its resonant tank circuit. The crystal oscillators are preferred when greater frequency stability is required. So, hence the crystals are used in watches, communication transistors, transmitters and receivers. So applications of the crystals are the watches, communication transmitters and receivers, etc. Okay, this is the symbolic representation. So quartz is inexpensive and easily available in nature, and hence very commonly used in the crystal oscillators. This is the construction. The natural shape of the quartz crystal is a hexagonal. Okay, but for the practical use, it cut the rectangular slab. This is the rectangular slab. The slab is then mounted between the two metal plates. The symbolic representation of each such a practical crystal is this one. The metal plates are called the holding plates. This is the holding plates. As they hold the crystal slab in between them. Okay. AC equivalent circuit. This is the AC equivalent the circuit. When the crystal is not vibrating, suppose when the crystal is not vibrating, it's the equivalent to the capacitance due to the mechanical mounting of the crystal. Such a capacitance existing due to the two metal plates separated by the dielectric, just like capacitance, okay, is called the mounting capacitance, denoted by Cm. This is the Cm. So the equivalent capacitance due to the mechanical mounting of the crystal. So the capacitance existing due to two metal plates. These are all the metal plates. Okay, two metal plates separated by the dielectric like crystal slab. So this is called the mounting capacitance. So this is denoted by Cm or M, C. When it is vibrating, suppose when it is vibrating, there are internal frictional losses which are denoted by the resistance R, while the mass of the crystal, which is indication of its inertia, is represented by an inductance L. In vibrating conditions, it is having some stiffness, which is represented by the capacitor C. The mounting capacitance is a shunt capacitance. So, and its overall equivalent circuit of the crystal can be, this is the RLC and CM. RLC forms the resonating circuit. Okay, the expression for the resonating frequency FR equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC square root of Q square by 1 plus Q square, where Q is the quality factor of the crystal. Q is the omega L by R. The Q factor of the crystal is very high, typically 20,000. The value of Q up to 10 power 6 also, which can be achieved. Okay. So, the square root of Q square by 1 plus Q square factor approaches to unity, and we get the resonating frequency FR equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC. The crystal frequency, in fact, inversely proportional to the thickness of the crystal. So, that is the T is the thickness. So, frequency F is proportional to, inversely proportional to thickness, that is the F is inversely proportional to T, that is the F is directly proportional to 1 by T. Okay. So, to have the high frequencies, thickness of the crystal should be very small. But it makes the crystal mechanically weak, and hence it can get damaged under the vibrations. Hence, practically crystal oscillators are used up to 200 to 300 kilohertz. The crystal has two resonating frequencies, series resonant frequency and parallel resonating frequency. Okay. Series resonating and the parallel resonating. The series resonating frequency is same as the resonating frequency. So that is the Fs equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC. And at the parallel resonance, the equivalent capacitance is C equivalent equal to CMC by CM plus C. And the parallel resonating frequency is given by Fp equal to 1 by 2 pi square root of L equivalent. So when the crystal capacitance C is much smaller than the Cm, then the behavior of the crystal impedance and the frequency is like this. So in this, when crystal capacitance C is much smaller than the Cm, generally the values of in this Fs and Fp are very close to each other, and practically it can be said that there exists only one resonating frequency per crystal. The higher value of the Q is main advantage of the crystal. Due to high Q of the resonating circuit, it provides very good frequency stability. If we neglect the resistance R, the impedance of the crystal is a reactance Jx, which depends on the frequency. Okay. So Jx equal to minus J by omega Cm into omega square minus omega square S by omega square minus omega square P, where omega S equal to series resonating frequency and omega P equal to parallel resonating frequency. The oscillating frequency lies between omega S and omega P. Okay, and the next one, crystal stability. Okay, so in this is the temperature stability and the precise crystal oscillator, and the next one, Miller crystal oscillator. So this is the crystal oscillator. In this, F1, R1, R2 are the two biasing resistors, and RFC is the radio frequency choke, RE is parallel with the CE. Okay, this is the tank circuit and this is the crystal. C1, C2 are the parallel, and this is the crystal. The Colpitts oscillator can be modified by using the crystal. Okay, to have an inductor. The circuit is called the precise crystal oscillator. The crystal behaves as an inductor for a frequency slightly higher than the series resonating frequency Fs. The two capacitors C1, C2 required in tank circuit along with an inductor are used in the Colpitts oscillator. So in this Colpitts oscillator, C1, C2 in crystal place lo inductance. Okay, that is the Colpitts oscillator. As only inductor gets replaced by the crystal, we behave as an inductor. The basically working principle of precise crystal oscillator is same as the Colpitts oscillator. The resistances R1, R2, RE, these three, R1, R2, RE provides the DC bias, while the capacitor CE is the emitter bypass capacitor, and RFC is the radio frequency choke. It provides the isolation between the AC and DC operations. CC1 and CC2 are the coupling capacitors. These two are the coupling capacitors. Okay, so the resulting frequency, circuit frequency, is set by the series resonating frequency of the crystal. Suppose change in the supply voltage, temperature, transistor parameters have no effect on the circuit operating conditions, and hence good frequency stability is obtained. In the crystals, good stability, frequency stability. The oscillator circuit can be modified by using internal capacitors of the transistors are used instead of C1 and C2. To separate the C1, C2 are not required in such circuit. Okay, this is the circuit diagrams using the FET, using transistor. This is the using FET and this is the using transistor. And the next one, Miller crystal oscillator. This is the circuit diagram. Similar to the modifications in the Colpitts oscillator, the Hartley oscillator circuit can be modified to get the Miller crystal oscillator. In crystal oscillator circuit, two inductors and one capacitor is required in the tank circuit. One inductor is replaced by the crystal, same as, which act as an inductor for the frequencies slightly greater than the resonating series resonating frequency. So this is the transistorized Miller crystal oscillator circuit. In this, the tuned circuit of L1 and C, okay, this is the L1 and C, is of tuned to behave an inductance, and that is the L1. The crystal behaves an other inductance L2, is between the base and the ground. The internal capacitance of the transistor act as an capacitor required to fulfill the elements of the tank circuit. The crystal decides the operating frequency of the oscillator. Okay, this is the Miller crystal oscillator, and these and next one problems and frequency stability of the oscillators. Okay, in the next class we will discuss.